In this video, we'll see what is an oblique asymptote. Now, by the definition of an asymptote, an oblique or slant asymptote is an oblique line correspond to the curve of some function such that the distance between the curve and the line approaches to zero as the curve and the line grow in same direction. That means this distance is getting smaller and smaller. Then this line is called an oblique asymptote of this curve or of this function. So let's do it in an example. Let's say the function is 2x squared plus 6x minus 2 divided by x plus 1. Now we have to find an oblique asymptote of this function if there is any. That means we have to check the end behavior of this function. That means we have to find the limit of this function when x is approaching to positive or negative infinity. Now this is a rational function. So to find an oblique asymptote, first of all we have to check that the degree of the numerator should be 1 more than the degree of denominator. The degree of numerator must be equal to 1 more than the degree of denominator. This is very important. Now here the degree is 2 and in denominator the degree is 1. So there will be an oblique asymptote of this function. So to find that, I'll take the limit x approaches to infinity of this function 2x squared plus 6x minus 2 divided by x plus 1. Now to solve this limit, I'll use the long division method to split this function. So the dividend is 2x squared plus 6x minus 2 and the divisor is x plus 1. Now to divide this, what I have to do, I have to make the first term over here same as this term. So I have to multiply this term with some value so that I get the same term over here as this. So if I multiply this whole expression with 2x, so what do I get? 2x into x, that means 2x square plus 2x. So when I subtract it, these terms get cancelled. And we get 4x minus 2. And again, now if I multiply this expression by plus 4, so what do I get? 4x plus 4. So when I change the sign, these terms get cancelled. So the remainder is minus 6. So how can I write it? Quotient, that means 2x plus 4 plus remainder, that means minus 6 over the divisor, that is x plus 1. So by long division, I wrote this expression as this. Now it's very easy to simplify this expression. Now here we see x is approaching to infinity. Then this whole term is approaching to 0 as the denominator is getting arbitrarily large. When x is approaching to infinity, this term is approaching to 0. So that means when x is approaching to infinity, this expression is equivalent to 2x plus 4 when x is approaching to infinity, which is a linear expression, which is a line. So this will be the oblique asymptote for this function. Let's make the graph x dash y dash. Now 2x plus 4 line will be like that, and the graph of this function looks like this. Now here we see when x is approaching to infinity, then this function is approaching to 2x plus 4. That means when x is approaching to infinity, this curve is almost becoming the line 2x plus 4. And from the other side also, when x will be approaching to negative infinity, this curve will almost be the line 2x plus 4 from this side also. Now here we can think that maybe when x is approaching to infinity, that then somewhere this curve will meet this line. For that, look here very carefully. Now here when x is approaching to infinity, this term is approaching to 0. This term will never be equal to 0. This term is just approaching to 0. That means the value of this term is very, very close to 0, but never equal to 0. This value is never equal to 0, but very close to 0. That means there will be some distance between this line, and this curve, because here this term is just approaching to 0. So from both sides, the curve is never gonna touch this line. So that means this is an oblique asymptote of this function. So 2x plus 4 y equals to 2x plus 4 is an oblique asymptote of this function. Now one more thing, here I mentioned that the degree of numerator must be equal to 1 more than the degree of denominator. Now what if the degree is more than 1 plus degree of denominator? The degree of numerator is more than 1 plus the degree of denominator. So let's take some function 2x cube plus 2x square plus x plus 1 divided by x plus 2. So here, if I do the long division, I get, okay, let's write x plus 2. So I will multiply this expression by 2x square. So I get 2x cube plus 4x square. Subtracted, these term get cancelled. So I get 2x square plus x plus 1. Now again, if I multiply this term with minus 2x, I get minus 2x square minus 4x. Change the sign, these term get cancelled. So it's 5x plus 1, and now I'll multiply this expression by plus 5. So I get 5x plus 10, change the signs, so the remainder is left negative 9. So how can I write this expression? 2x square minus 2x plus 5 plus minus 9 over divisor, that means x plus 2. Now here we took some function where the degree of numerator is more than 1 plus degree of denominator. Now when x approaches to infinity here, when x will approach to infinity, then this term will approach to 0, and we are left with a non-linear expression. Now as an oblique or slant asymptote is a line, it is a linear equation, that means it's a line. So if the degree is more than 1 plus the degree of denominator, If the degree of numerator is more than 1 plus the degree of denominator, then here we will be left with a non-linear expression. So that means there will be no oblique asymptote. No oblique asymptote. So it's very important that the degree of numerator must be equal to 1 more than the degree of denominator.